Hi, my name is Donna, and today I'm going to be showing you how to draw the YouTube logo. Things that you're going to need are colored pencils or markers, a ruler, a pencil, and either a Bic fine point marker or a pen. So first, you're going to start out with your ruler, and we're going to use it from 0 to just put it in the middle of the paper. We're going to go up just a bit. So then, I'm going to go straight line down in a very small way. You're just going to make a little line that goes down. About to the 13 mark. Wait, no. Let's do the 16 mark. Let's make it a bit bigger. Sort of like that. So now once you're done with that, draw a little ball down there. Then you're going to want to take it and go to the middle of 30 and 0, and that is 15 right there. So now what you're going to want to do is go about to the 25 and the 5.
So my project is, can we create origami folds and can we teach others how to make them? So these are the things
you can. You want to make two ball points right there. And then you're going to go ahead, take it out to 15 again, and go about to the 7, so you can make that nice curve.
Unfortunately, I did not get as far on the dragon, but it kind of looks like a dragon.
Then it's going to make a little nice curve.
Origami squirrel. So the first one I'm going to make is the box. So first you got to fold this.
I actually have a tip for this. Hold on, let me use it. So put the 15 right there at your line. Let's see, oh, it's at the 7. Okay, so bring your ruler down, but keep it at the 15. And make your line extend to the 15. And make it about 3 centimeters away from the top. Sort of like that. So now we're going to go down. Go to the line. Sort of like that. So now you're just going to do that in all 4 corners. But before you do that, make your line look just a bit more whiny, not sort of boxy. So I think what I'm going to do is I might do like the pattern where there's 2 things or it's just the normal play button. Hold on. I'm just gonna do something real quick.
Yeah. Place scissors in a square. You gotta push. This each side in.
Let's see. I think I'm going to do. Ooh, that's another good idea. I could do the actual thing. I could do the little play button like that.
So it should end up like this.
Or I could do the little YouTube.
About to like break.
Ooh, this would be a great option to ask whoever watches my videos what to do, but I think for the sake of it, since I already have all the colors, I think, and I also have the shape, I'm gonna do the little play button, the little triangle. So, alright, let's get back to drawing. So now you're going to just want to do the same thing on the very other side. So Go to the centimeters. Go to the number 15. And then go 7 above. If you don't know what that is, that's 22. But just throwing it out there. So I want to go to 22. Okay, now that that is there. We went to about 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, I'm gonna go to the 22, I think. Does that look about right? I think I'm gonna go to the 24. Just maybe in case. Yeah, that's sort of right, but not to the point of where I want it, so I guess I should go, like, 25 at the end, so I'm gonna just, like, erase it to about 23. Okay, now that that is done, you're gonna do the same thing. Gonna make a little curve, but you're gonna want to do my little tip that I taught you. You want to go out to the, you want to bring it down just a bit, about 3 centimeters down. That was about right there. Well,
have a lid like this.
Say about right there. So now that you're right there, you're gonna bring it out to the 25.
You can have it like hold it, and then you want to go down, and it creates a box. And now I'm going to show you the, so now you're just going to make a bit more circle-ish, go like that, and then same on the outside as well.
Show like an extra layer outside, and that should help. So now that you have that done, you can officially erase the top part up here, but you want to keep this line right there. So now you're just going to go down and just erase that line, erase that little ballpoint. If you have to, you can regel that line over where you erase the ballpoint. So now we're going to do the same thing over here. I'm going to take the 15. Okay. Okay. Now that I have that fixed, since it was accidentally crooked and I didn't know, so that's a good little tip for you. Just make sure your line isn't crooked and you should be good to go. So again, you're going to do the same thing, and if you want to, you can skip ahead in the video till where I do the little triangle. So go about to the 15, we'll go to the 7. Go. Go about like 3 centimeters down to like right about there, and curve over to the 5. That line was one of the more awful lines I've done. And then you're just going to want to curve it more if you can. Then just start heading down to the line. Okay, now you're just going to do it to the other side as well, and then you're done with the main, like, piece that is the actual YouTube logo. You probably already know the steps, so I'm not going to say, like, oh, the 15, go down, like, and then go to, like, the 24, and then go down all the way to, like, the 26, or 25, or, no, go down to the 23, and then go down to the 25, and that stuff, so I'm not going to say that.
Hello,
so.
My name is Harvey, and I'm going to show you how to make an origami squirrel. So, today, so you cut out the square of a piece of paper,
and then
you take the part that came off. So you fold.
I'm going to curve it to the 25.
This in half.
Now your main base is done. So now you can erase this line up here, and this and these two lines are done.
They're spelled district spelling lists, are they? You create your own, right?
I took them from school.
And another thing you're going to want to do is erase all your ball points. Alright, now that you have your main base done, you just want to go over the erasing again, just in case you missed any spots. So, now that I'm done with that, you can finally go ahead and start drawing the actual main piece. So, we're just going to want to So from what it looks like here, you're going to want to start the middle like right there. No, sorry, not the middle, but the, you know, starting point of the actual line. And to do that, I want to go down, say about a good, go until about like 16, so start from 10, then go to 16, and that's where we'll actually leave it, but it actually doesn't look that right, so I'm going to go from 10, and I think I'm going to go to 18. Okay, now that that is done, you can create the two little lines right there, and then we'll get to the shading. Okay, so start from the 0. And I say go about to right there, and then go to the 8. And then do the same thing with the other side. But it doesn't look that equal. So I think we have to go to the 9. Well, 8.5. 8.5. We'll try the 8.5, and then if that doesn't work, try something else. Okay. So it looks to be about the 9 that it wants to go to, but that is completely fine. So, right about there. There you go. Now you get your main frame right there. Erase your ball points. Okay, so now that the main logo is done, now we can get to the shading. So one thing that you're going to do is recommended is use your ruler and sort of just make like a little crease just right there and sort of just shade that part in. So now that that is done, you can do the same, but on the other side, just make like a little crease. So just make it go out. Now that that is done, you can sort of just really lightly go over the whole entire thing. And now that you have that done, you can move on to the next part. So the next part I recommend myself is now doing stuff with a fine point pen. So basically all you're going to do is just sort of shade, sort of just run over this line right here on the outside of the thing, and then if you want to, which I'm going to do, is color in that those little lines that you just made, and then I'm going to do the outside. And then once I'm done with that, I'm going to erase all the pencil markings, and then we'll be good to go.
So my name is Harvey, and today I'm going to show you how I learned to make an origami dragon, an origami squirrel, an origami box, and an origami T-Rex. I used these. And if you just click on it, go to my website called my partner's not here today, so I have to say our website, and call it Central. It's called centralorigami.weebly.com. And so if you click on it, click play on the thing, you can go right to YouTube and straight to the video that showed me and my partner how to make them. Same with every single one of you.
There we go. Now, just go over the lines on the outside.
So, I know by memory how to make the origami box, because it was really easy to make. So it's like this. This is what it looks like. So I would like to. I have to show something on the camera. So I know how to make a box, but this is the origami T-Rex that I made from the video. From the person who made it was Joe Nakashima. I'm sorry if I mispronounced it. I got that from him. So this is the T-Rex that I made from the video.
There you go.
I made this origami squirrel.
So now that you're done with that,
you're
just going to want to fill in the outside with red. And if you want to, you can make like gold and silver little sparkles on the outside. I'm going to cover this with some silver. And inside, I guess I could do like some gold and make it like the golden play button or something like that. I might do that in a later video. So now we're just going to do like fill it in with silver and fill the outside with red and maybe do some red and silver on the outside.
On YouTube. So it's right here.
So let me just get my good red out.
Yeah. This is the... And,
looking for a more darker red. Yeah, that looks about right. Okay. So now that I have this, I'm just gonna fill in all of this.
Never mind. But the dragon, my partner made that, but I can't get it because he has it, and I don't know where he put it because he's out. He's not here today, so I have to. So it's time for me to and this. I would like to thank these people who make these videos. That's how we made this thing. That's my life. That's my session. I don't know. Bye.
I sure look pretty good with the red. Just something was behind me and I didn't know what it was, but it was just a person, so. My pencil, then I'll be right back. So now that I am back, let's finish drawing the logo, at least I hope, with just this amount of red. So, let's go. Sorry if this part is a bit boring, but I'm mostly concentrating on the drawing right now, so if you want to skip ahead, that's completely fine. Thank you. Yeah, I'll be right back since I have to sharpen it just one more time. Alright, now that I'm done with that, I'm gonna go ahead and sort of just draw the rest of the red in, and then we should be done. Well, except for the sparkles outside, but with the inside red, we should be done. Because, well, I might actually add some blue in there, because, you know, the gold, the silver, and the red play button. No, the gold, the silver, and the diamond play button. There is a ruby play button that only PewDiePie has got, but it would sort of, like, well, I guess I could, so. Before I actually did this, I was thinking about if I wanted to put, like, a YouTuber's logo on there, but, I figured that would be way too hard. Since it's like a 2-in-1 video of draw the YouTube logo and someone's logo inside. So. Let me erase this just real quick. I'm sorry for the third time, possibly. I need to go sharpen this again. I know what you're saying. Why don't you just get a handheld one? I don't have one. Okay, back for possibly the last time I had to do that, so I'm sorry that I had to do that, and let's finish this. I think we're done with coloring, so final product I think looks pretty good. So I mean, the triangle could be a bit better, but it's my first time drawing this. So let's go ahead and find the silver, and we'll draw the inside silver. Gold right there, but that's only going to be used on the outside. Oh, here's the silver. Right there. See, that's the gold that I'm going to be using it a lot. I think that looks actually pretty darn cool. Okay, so now for the final part, we're just going to draw some sparkles. I might write YouTube down there and the logo that it is. Yeah, it's actually not a half bad idea. Yeah, let's do it. Okay, so before I do anything, I'm just going to do that real quick. I have it up, so. So I figured while you guys are waiting for me to finish drawing this video, I'd talk about some news. It's been going on social media, aka YouTube, that would probably fit in to this video. Almost every single YouTuber is playing the new game Resident Evil Biohazard. That's pretty cool. Definitely gonna be watching some of that. Let's see. Oh yeah, there's this Japanese girl. She was on YouTube, and apparently she was in it for the money and none of the fame. All she wanted was the money, so she got banned from YouTube, I think. And a new clickbaiter has been revealed. I think his name is like DRTXYZ, Drixing, or however you say his name, but I don't even know, so I'm not even gonna try to defend him and say, this boy clickbaited me. But that doesn't even make sense, so. Well, it does. I could say, like, scammer, I got scammed by, like, this really famous YouTuber. So funny. Like, I need you guys' help, please send me money, like that stuff, but that's not real. If you see a video saying, like, please donate me money, I'm poor and I need it, if the quality is good on their video, do not give them any money, because they already have good equipment, so either they are poor and they spent all their money on the equipment, or they're not poor and they have all this equipment, and they're lying and they're only in it for the money. So, just a little discussion with you guys, because I'm almost done, so. Okay, now I'm gonna read. Now I'm gonna need our red marker and sort of just color it. And we're gonna color the outside black. Now that we have that done, we're gonna go ahead and just
1 minute if you can help it.
Okay. We're just gonna go ahead and color in the inside, but not the letters. Finished. Okay, now that is done, we're just gonna draw some gold. Silver, red, and gold sparkles on the outside. Let me just find my gold. Oh, wait, there it is. And then we're gonna do some blue as well. Finished up with little sparkles. So, alright, done the silver and the red.
Are you done? You did, are you?
So now we're gonna do double blue. Since I thought it looked good. Yeah. Now we have the final color, the gold. And there you go. You have your finished product of the YouTube symbol. Thank you for watching my tutorial.